Thank you for choosing to watch this brief video update. I'm sure you will not only find this the most astounding information you have ever learned, but you'll also find the conclusion absolutely shocking. It becomes increasingly interesting as the video develops, so be patient in the beginning minutes, especially if you are already familiar with the information. Make sure you watch this video to its end. I want to make this video as short as possible so that people will choose to watch it. So I'm going to speak quickly and cover a lot of information in a short period. It isn't complicated information, but you'll need to pay close attention to everything said. Make sure you are in a position to be able to focus while watching this. First, I will very quickly summarize four of the major prophetic signs that occurred this autumn. For amazing details on these signs, you need to watch my video number 5. After this brief summary, I will then explain the absolutely amazing and shocking update. If you watched my last video update I made in late November and are familiar with the information, you could skip to minute 12 and a half if you wished, or you could watch again a quick summary of the major amazing signs this last year. The Revelation 12 sign in a nutshell, the quote, great sign in heaven, quote, in the book of Revelation chapter 12 is the sign of the rapture. The rapture is the event before the end times period of 7 years that comes before the 1,000 years messianic age. The rapture is when the overcomers and faithful followers of Jesus disappear, sparing them from the coming tribulation. Widely available modern astronomy software allows anyone to easily view and animate the night sky at any time in history or the future. For example, we now know what the Star of Bethlehem was and how it lines up with all 9 clues in the book of Matthew. The discovery of what it was explains, for example, why the Magi from Babylon knew what about it and everyone else didn't, and also how the star stopped over Bethlehem on December 25th, 2 BC. The details are in my video number 5. The Revelation 12 sign, that is the rapture sign, is a celestial alignment in the night sky with many moving parts that make it so rare it occurs only once in all of human history. This includes a 42-week circular retrograde motion of Jupiter strictly inside the womb of the constellation Virgo. This Revelation 12 sign occurred on September 23rd. The details are in my video number 5. Quote, a woman clothed in the sun, quote. The sun is in Virgo for almost a month every year from late August to September, quote, with the moon under her feet, quote. This addition to the sign narrows down the possible dates for this sign to a couple days per year around the autumnal equinox, quote, and a crown of 12 stars, quote. Above Virgo is Leo, which is associated with Christ's royal lineage in the Bible and is made up of 9 principal stars. Mercury, Mars, and Venus make this 12 stars and makes this sign exceedingly rare. The planets also line up symmetrically, and Mercury, the messenger planet, makes a perfect retrograde motion around Regulus, which is known as the King Star. Quote, she was pregnant and crying out in birth pains, quote. Jupiter, which is the Messiah planet to the Jews, does an exceedingly rare retrograde motion inside the womb for 42 weeks, which is a regular human gestation. This addition to the sign makes it once in human history. The Great American Eclipse. The Great American Eclipse passed over the entire continental U.S. on August 21st. As you will see, this was a sign of impending judgment on America. Genesis 1:14 says the, quote, lights in the expanse of the heavens are for prophetic signs and appointed times, quote. The, quote, grand coincidence, quote, is the name scientists use to refer to the fact that the sun is exactly 400 times larger than the moon and also exactly 400 times further away, producing perfect solar eclipses. Like the Roman and Greek alphabets, each letter in the Hebrew alphabet has a numeric value. The numeric value of the last letter is 400. Additionally, each letter is a symbol for something. This last letter in the Hebrew alphabet is the symbol for prophetic signs. So unless they knew modern astronomy 3,000 years ago, whoever created the Hebrew alphabet also created eclipses. Here in point form is a list of the things about this eclipse. This eclipse's path is an uncanny division of the nation in half. The eclipse only touched the U.S. and no other country or island. The last time an eclipse only touched the U.S. was in 1776, the year the nation was founded, which is fitting if this sign indicates the end of the nation as we know it. The first minute the eclipse's path of totality first cast its shadow of darkness on the west coast in Oregon was the exact same minute of sunset in Israel. The same applies to darkness first touching Salem, Oregon, and sunset in Jerusalem. The path of totality went directly over 7 cities named Salem. 7 is used over 500 times in the Bible to show God's touch upon something. The word Salem is Hebrew for peace. The sun going to darkness would imply no peace. Salem, Kentucky is exactly where the eclipse peaked. The eclipse entered the U.S. in Oregon, the 33rd state, and exited the U.S. on the 33rd parallel in South Carolina. The eclipse occurred 33 days before the Revelation 12 sign. Where the eclipse peaked is coincidentally exactly in the path of totality of the next great American eclipse that divides the U.S. in half 7 years from now, this time going from south to north. The paths of both eclipses together form an X or a cross or a Tav mark. Tav is the name of the last letter in the Hebrew alphabet that has a numeric value of 400 and is the symbol for prophetic signs. In Ezekiel chapter 9, a Tav mark was placed on the foreheads of those with a loyalty and zeal for God. Their lives were spared during the judgment and destruction of Jerusalem, while those without this shibboleth were not spared. This is a prophetic foreshadow of the coming mark of the beast. Where the Great American Eclipse peaked is the epicenter of the New Madrid seismic zone, the location of the strongest earthquakes in U.S. history. The path of totality went directly over all of the seismic hot zones in the U.S. The date of the eclipse was the first day of the month of Elul in the Jewish calendar. This is 40 days before the Day of Atonement and is the beginning of what is called the season of repentance. After the Day of Atonement, it is too late to atone for sin. There were two other famous eclipses in history that occurred on Elul 1, the beginning of the season of repentance. The Ber-Sagael eclipse in 763 BC is the most documented and famous eclipse in ancient history. It passed directly over ancient Nineveh just before Jonah arrived to preach 40 days of repentance or else judgment and destruction for the city. In the Bible, Jonah is recorded as being a contemporary of the king of Nineveh at this time. The discovery of the eponym cuneiform tablets reveal there were two plagues and a civil war in Nineveh in the 2 years leading up to the eclipse. These calamities and the eclipse prior to Jonah arriving explains why the Ninevites were mysteriously more than ready to receive Jonah's warning and repent, even though Jonah was a stranger and from the enemy tribe. In 1914, another famous eclipse occurred on August 21st, and also Elul 1, just as World War I got underway. It also went directly over where ancient Nineveh was. Every empire the Path of Totality touched met its demise as a result of World War I, including the Russian, Austro-Hungarian, German, and Ottoman empires. Also, where this eclipse peaked is coincidentally the site of the only battle said to have been any importance on the outcome and result of the war. Early in the war, had the Germans fared a little worse or a little better in defeating the Russians at this Battle of Tannenberg, the outcome of World War I would have been entirely different. Deuteronomy 19:15 describes how, quote, two or three witnesses are required to confirm a matter and establish a charge, quote. The three major hurricanes to wreak havoc on America directly following the eclipse confirmed this sign of impending judgment. The path of totality of the Great American Eclipse ended in the middle of the Atlantic and made a direct bullseye on Hurricane Harvey. The eyewall of Harvey landed in Corpus Christi, which means Body or Church of Christ, Texas, 4 days later and was the costliest natural disaster in U.S. history. The eclipse occurring on the 21st and Harvey landing on the 25th points to Luke 21:25, quote, and there will be signs in the sun and moon and stars, and on the earth distress of nations, in perplexity because of the roaring of the sea and the waves, quote. This was only a partial fulfillment of Luke 21:25, as Harvey pointing to this verse is in itself a sign pointing to greater calamity to come involving, quote, the roaring of the sea and the waves, quote. Then Hurricane Irma, the strongest hurricane ever recorded in the Atlantic, pummeled the entire Florida peninsula. Then, unprecedented destruction came to Puerto Rico with Hurricane Maria in what was classified not as a disaster, but rather a catastrophe. Maria busted a major dam a couple days before the Revelation 12 sign, which depicts a birth, and therefore the dam breaking symbolized the woman's water breaking before birth. Hurricane Jose, or Joseph, was said to have affected Hurricane Maria, or Mary, prior to this water breaking that symbolizes a birth. There were more witnesses to this sign of impending judgment than hurricanes. More superlative events hit the U.S. after the eclipse. Besides the costliest and strongest hurricanes, there was the official deadliest and costliest wildfires in history, the worst mass shooting in history, and the worst mass shooting in a church in history. Incidentally, the worst mass shooting prior to Las Vegas was in 2015 in an Orlando gay nightclub on the day of Pentecost. Pentecost means 50, as it was when Moses came down Mount Sinai after 50 days to find the Jews in open hedonistic rebellion. 50 people died in this shooting. Before the Revelation 12 sign and the Great American Eclipse / Sign of Jonah, there was another massive sign on July 17th. In the book of Daniel, chapter 9, Archangel Gabriel explains to Daniel that there are 70 sets of 7 years to come for the Jews and their expected Messiah. He described how after 69 sets of 7 years, from the decree to rebuild Jerusalem and its walls, would be the arrival of the Messiah. The decree was recorded later in the book of Nehemiah chapter 2 as being the first day in the Jewish calendar in the year 445 BC, and this is confirmed by the Royal British Observatory as being March 14th, 445 BC. The details are in my video number 2. 69 times 7 years equals 483 years. All ancient cultures use 360-day calendars, as does the Bible, including another prophecy. So 483 years times 360 days equals 173,880 days. March 14th, 445 BC, plus 173,880 days, equals April 6th, 32 AD, the day of Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem as king on what is known as Palm Sunday. Jesus was crucified on a Passover in 32 AD, and April 6th is confirmed by the Royal British Observatory as being the Sunday before Passover. This prophecy speaks of the Messiah being killed and then afterward a period of, quote, desolations, quote, before the prophecy's resumption with the final set of 7 years. The 70th set of 7 years, for which Israel was restored in the 20th century, is the end times period. What is amazing also is that the 69 sets of 7 years until the arrival of the Messiah in Daniel chapter 9 is actually broken into 62 sets of 7 years and 7 sets of 7 years. We find an amazing parallel to this in history when, in 1535, Suleiman the Magnificent decreed that Jerusalem and its walls be rebuilt. 62 sets of 7 years later, on April 1st, 1969, the Knesset in Israel officially voted to rebuild Old Jerusalem and created the JQDC to oversee this. The other 7 sets of 7 years from this date in 1969 couldn't be more astonishing. 7 sets of 7 years, or 49, times 360 days, brings us exactly to July 17th, 2017, the very day that for one day only, in the aftermath of terrorism on the Temple Mount, the Jews were openly walking around and praying on the Temple Mount, for the first time in 50 years since Jews briefly controlled the Temple Mount in 1967. Thus, we have 62 sets of 7 years from Suleiman the Magnificent to the decree in 1969, and then 7 sets of 7 years to 2017, for a total of 69 sets of 7 years. Therefore, the remaining 70th set of 7 years, the end times period, begins this year. Very briefly, a blood moon's tetrad is 4 total lunar eclipses in a row that all occur on Jewish feast days in the spring and autumn in a 2-year period and have no lunar eclipses in between them. The last 4 blood moons tetrads have coincided with war or calamity for Jewish people, including the expulsion of Jews from Spain in 1492, what had been their main homeland for 1,000 years, the rebirth of Israel in 1948, and the capture of their ancient capital, Jerusalem, in 1967. As I will show, the significance of the blood moons tetrad of 2014-2015 is equally stunning. Last on my list of signs to summarize briefly are the Jupiter-Venus conjunctions of 2015, 2016, and 2017. It is believed by many, myself included, that the Jupiter-Venus conjunctions in 2 BC was part of what was the Star of Bethlehem that the Magi recognized. Again, the fascinating details of the Star of Bethlehem are in my video number 5. In 2015, the mainstream media was excited about the Jupiter-Venus conjunction on July 1st and was touting it as the closest and brightest in 2,000 years since the, quote, Star of Bethlehem, quote. 3 Jupiter-Venus conjunctions have occurred in the last 3 years that are in the league of the conjunction in 2 BC. The degree of separation of these planets' conjunctions in 2015, 2016, and 2017 are 0.3, 0.03, and 0.3 degrees respectively. It will be many more years before another conjunction as close and bright. Now that we have these recent signs briefly summarized and this background information explained, let's look at what is the most shocking information you have ever learned. Our God is a mathematical God. He uses numbers to reveal himself, and the Bible and the world around us are replete with numbers that unmistakably point to him. This is certainly the case with these signs in relation to each other, and as you will see, no one but our Creator could have procured such perfection. Numbers are objective, not subjective. There is no misinterpreting the language of numbers, which is a reason God uses them. Okay, let's examine this illustration, but please focus precisely on what I'm saying as we go through it and avoid being distracted with other things in this diagram. The diagrams in this video are courtesy of watchfortheday.org. I highly recommend this website. Okay, first, in this timeline, we have the Revelation 12 sign on September 23rd, 2017. The astounding celestial alignment described in verse 1 and 2 was fulfilled on this day. Again, this is the rapture sign, and it is the birth of the church into heaven, and is depicted in the sign as a woman in labor and then giving birth. Here is the Jupiter-Venus conjunction on November 13th that depicts verse 5 of Revelation 12 when the child is, quote, caught up, quote, to heaven. In the Revelation 12 sign, Jupiter symbolizes the church. In the book of Revelation, Jesus says he is the morning star and also described the rapture as giving the church the morning star. The morning star is Venus, and so Venus symbolizes Christ. The Bible also describes the rapture as when Jesus meets his church in the sky. So this joining of Venus with Jupiter is verse 5 symbolically fulfilled. So September 23rd is the start of the Revelation 12 sign, and the Jupiter-Venus conjunction is the completion of the Revelation 12 sign. Okay, let's start from the first blood moon of the blood moon's tetrad on April 15th, 2014, which is not shown in this diagram. It is 1260 days from this day to the Revelation 12 sign. 1260 is a highly significant number and is mentioned seven times in prophecy as being the length of time of the Antichrist kingdom in the end times. From the last blood moon on September 28th, 2015, it is 726 days to the Revelation 12 sign. This is also not depicted in this diagram. 726 is the number for the word harpazo in Strong's Concordance, the universally used reference for the original Koine Greek in the New Testament. Harpazo is the word for rapture used in verse 5 of Revelation 12. So from the last blood moon, the number for the word for rapture in the original Greek points to the rapture sign. Then, it is 777 days from the last blood moon to the Jupiter-Venus conjunction on November 13th, which is the completion of the Revelation 12 rapture sign. The number 7 is the number showing the touch of God upon something and the number of completion. So the last blood moon not only points to the rapture sign on September 23rd, but it also points to the completion of the rapture sign on November 13th. It turns out that the second blood moon in this tetrad also has what looks to be a divine relationship. It isn't shown in this diagram either, but it is 1,131 days from it until the Jupiter-Venus conjunction and completion of the Revelation 12 rapture sign. 1,131 is 360 times pi. 360 is the number of days in a biblical calendar year, and 1,131 days subtract 777 is 354 days, which is the length of a lunar year. 360 is the number of degrees in a circle, and the number for pi is not only the ratio of the circumference of a circle to its radius, but it is also a mysterious number that shows up in mathematics in ways unrelated to a circle and is found throughout creation. As we will now see, in December, God chose to clearly and unmistakably single out for us the eighth day and symbolic last day of the Jewish holiday of Hanukkah. This eighth day of Hanukkah began at sunset on December 19th and went until sunset December 20th, 2017. A few hours later was the historic and massively prophetic UN vote on Jerusalem. Just as God has clearly pointed to November 13th and the Jupiter-Venus conjunction, which symbolizes verse 5 of the Revelation 12 sign, God has also clearly and undeniably pointed to this day of December 20th and 8th day of Hanukkah and the UN vote. It is amazing, and I will explain this, but first, allow me to briefly explain the enormous and prophetic significance of this day. Once again, your patience will be highly rewarded. A rudimentary understanding of the Bible and Bible prophecy informs us that the nation of Israel will be restored again at the closing of the age. The Hebrews were brought out of Egypt to the Promised Land in the middle of the 15th century BC. To learn more about the archaeological proof of this, watch the award-winning documentary Patterns of Evidence, Exodus, or go to the additional resources section of my website. Then the Jews were exiled to Babylon for 70 years, and then restored to Israel again in the 6th century BC. Prophecy tells us that the current day restoration of the Jews to the land of Israel that began in the late 19th century is the second and final restoration. The Bible is a history book. No other world religion is tied to history like Judaism and Christianity. Either the events described in the Bible happened or they didn't. Other world religions are dependent on one man's vision or dream, like that of Muhammad's in the cave or Buddha's under the Bodhi tree. Their visions could have occurred in any other time in history and it would have made no difference to the religion. This is not the case with biblical Christianity, as this faith is interwoven into the fabric of history. God chose a relatively meek people, geographically at the crossroads of the ancient world, to begin his progressive divine self-revelation to the world. This divine self-revelation will climax with full divine self-revelation when God, manifested as Jesus Christ, takes his throne in Jerusalem at the dawning of the new millennium, the Messianic Age, 7 years from now. Other than the Jews, no other ancient people are still a people. One-third of the Bible is prophecy for the sake of God proving himself and proving the Bible is not just another collection of man-made stories and wisdom. Much of this prophetic proof comes through the history of the Jews. This passage speaks to this. Isaiah 44, 6-7. Thus says the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last. Besides me there is no God. Who is like me? Let him proclaim it. Let him declare and set it before me, since I appointed an ancient people. Let them declare what is to come and what will happen. The miraculous restoration of Jews from over 100 countries to Israel in the 20th century is the banner, or the biggest of all signs from God, that the end times period is at hand and that Bible prophecy proves the Bible and the God of Israel. Isaiah 11, 10-12. In that day, the root of Jesse, which is a messianic reference to Jesus, will stand as a banner for the peoples. The nations will rally to him. His resting place will be glorious. In that day, he will extend his hand yet a second time to recover the remnant that remains of his people. He will raise a banner for the nations and gather the exiles of Israel. He will assemble the scattered people of Judah from the four quarters of the earth. Zechariah 10:9. Though I scattered them among the nations, yet in far countries they shall remember me, and with their children they shall live and return. Jeremiah 16:14 through 15. However, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when it will no longer be said, as surely as the Lord lives, who brought the Israelites up out of Egypt, but it will be said, as surely as the Lord lives, who brought the Israelites up out of the land of the north and all of the countries where he had banished them. For I will restore them to the land I gave their ancestors. More is written about the end times period in the Bible than any other period, including the gospel period in the first century. The myriad of prophecies regarding Israel's final restoration in our present time not only include the restoration of Israel, but specifically the holy city of Jerusalem, and even more specifically the restoration of the temple on the Temple Mount. So it makes sense that God is singled out, and with a number of very clear signs is pointed to, the eighth day of Hanukkah, as the holidays of Hanukkah commemorate the rededication of the ancient temple in Jerusalem after a period of disuse. The eighth day of Hanukkah in 2017 coincided a few hours later with the historic vote at the UN to condemn Jerusalem as Israel's capital. This vote followed President Trump's decision 2 weeks earlier to move the U.S. embassy from Tel Aviv to Israel's capital, Jerusalem. Bible prophecy is replete with passages regarding how the world will gang up on Israel and seek to divide and destroy Israel in the end times. Zechariah 12, 1-3. The burden of the word of the Lord for Israel, saith the Lord, which stretcheth forth the heavens, and layeth forth the foundation of the earth, and formeth the spirit of man within him. Behold, I will make Jerusalem a cup of trembling unto all the people round about, when they shall be in the siege both against Judah and against Jerusalem. And in that day I will make Jerusalem a burdensome stone for all people. All that burden themselves with it shall be cut in pieces, though all the people of the earth be gathered together against it. Zechariah 11:9, and on that day I will seek to destroy all the nations that come against Jerusalem. Joel 3:1-3. For behold, in those days and at that time, when I restore the fortunes of Judah and Jerusalem, I will gather all the nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat, and I will enter into judgment with them there on behalf of my people and my heritage Israel, because they have scattered them among the nations and have divided up my land. My video number one on my YouTube channel has four absolutely astounding modern day examples of the manifestation of the following verse. You must watch my other five videos. However, one example of this, which is very minor in comparison to what is in my video, is how recently on the day the Iranian parliament voted to proclaim Jerusalem as the eternal capital of Palestine, Tehran suffered an earthquake that killed one person and was also the day the major anti-government protests in Iran started. Genesis 12:3. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all peoples on the earth will be blessed through you. The emergency session at the UN, hours after the eighth day of Hanukkah, to vote against Jerusalem as Israel's capital, was a vote against God's word and God. These nations are unwittingly falling into God's trap and final judgment. Our God is a God of laws, and because of this formal and official rejection of God in the world court that is the United Nations, God will now formally and officially commence judgment on the world. This judgment will likely begin after a very symbolic 42 days from the UN vote, as I will explain in a minute. Through condemning and persecuting Israel, these nations and the world are playing a role in God's plan to finally reveal to the Jews who their Messiah is when they finally call upon him out of desperation at the end of the 7 years end times period, or quote, Jacob's hour of trouble, quote, as it's called in the book of Jeremiah. Zechariah 12:10, and I will pour out on the house of David and the inhabitants of Jerusalem a spirit of grace and supplication. They will look upon me, the one that they have pierced, and they will mourn for him as one mourns for an only child, and grieve bitterly for him as one grieves for a firstborn son. The, quote, mystery of the blindness of the Jews, quote, as Paul described it, is truly a mystery, as it is exceedingly clear from Old Testament prophecy that Jesus is the Messiah. The removal of this mystery of the blindness of the Jews, and the Jews finally recognizing Jesus as their Messiah and God, will bring an end to and fulfill the, quote, times of the Gentiles, quote, and will complete the restoration of Israel, ushering in the messianic age of Jesus' rule of the world from Jerusalem. Zechariah 14:6. Then the survivors from all the nations that have attacked Jerusalem will go up year after year to worship the King, the Lord Almighty, and to celebrate the Festival of Tabernacles. Now that we've clearly established the historic and prophetic significance of Hanukkah Day 8 and this historic UN vote, let's return to the last blood moon again. It is 7 Gregorian calendar years, which is 2,557 days, divided by pi, from this blood moon until Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote. Again, Hanukkah is a Jewish holiday commemorating the rededication of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem after its destruction and a period of disuse in the 2nd century BC. So it is fitting that Hanukkah Day 8 be an important time marker just prior to the beginning of the end times period and the beginning of the 70th set of 7 years from Daniel chapter 9, when the temple will finally be rebuilt and rededicated by Christ at the end of the 7 years. So the last blood moon not only points to the beginning of the Revelation 12 rapture sign on September 23rd, with a number that means rapture in Greek, and also points to the completion of the Revelation 12 rapture sign on November 13th, with the number 777, that means completion. But it also points to the UN vote with a number that is 7 years of days, which, as a result of the UN vote, God will now initiate 7 years of judgment on the world, and at the same time will rescue and rapture his people, the faithful followers of Jesus. This is enough evidence for me personally, but of course God is far from finished. I will explain the 7 year timeline in a minute, but this last blood moon is also 3,333 days before the end of the timeline on November 11th, 2024, and it is also 333 days before the brightest of the three Jupiter-Venus conjunctions on August 27th, 2016, which had a degree of separation of the planets of an incredible 0.03 degrees. From this Jupiter-Venus conjunction in August of 2016, it is 444 days until the Jupiter-Venus conjunction on November 13th, 2017, which is the completion of the Revelation 12 verse 5 rapture sign. Also, from the 2016 conjunction, it is 777 divided by phi until Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote. Phi is the golden ratio, a mysterious and intriguing mathematical relationship that is found throughout creation and therefore is a signature of God's. So this conjunction, which was the closest at 0.03 degrees separation, points to the completion of the Revelation 12 verse 5 rapture sign by being in the middle of a 777-day count, and also points to Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote with a 777-day count. Next on the list of the countdown to the end times 7 year period is the day the Jews openly prayed on the Temple Mount for the first time. From this day, it is 120 days until the completion of the Revelation 12 verse 5 rapture sign on November 13th. God gave the number 120 to Noah when he referred to the length of time it would be until the flood. Noah and his family were the only ones that would believe the warning of the impending judgment, as everyone considered them foolish. Them entering the ark symbolizes the rapture and the rescuing of the saints before judgment. The number 120 shows up again as the number of days from the impending judgment sign that was the Great American Eclipse on August 21st until Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote. So we have 120 days until the completed verse 5 of the rapture sign, and also 120 days until the UN vote that leads to God's judgment and the rapture event 42 days later, as I will explain in a minute. The Great American Eclipse on Elul 1 in the Hebrew calendar was also the 120th year anniversary of the first Zionist conference in 1897 to create a Jewish homeland in Israel, which further confirms this 120 number as a sign. From the day the Jews openly prayed on the Temple Mount for the first time, it is 490 days times pi until Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote. This is absolutely stunning, because as stated earlier, this day of Jews openly praying on the Temple Mount was exactly 49 times 360-day years from the decree to rebuild Jerusalem in 1969, and also 69 sets of 7 years from Suleiman the Magnificent's decree in 1535. All of this speaks to the prophecy in Daniel chapter 9 about Jerusalem and 70 sets of 7 years, which is 490 years. So here we have this 490 number pointing to the historic UN vote on Jerusalem and soon the beginning of the 70th set of 7 years from Daniel chapter 9, which concerns 490 years for the Jewish people and the arrival of the Messiah, 483 years being the time until Jesus' first coming, and the remaining 7 years from the beginning of the end times period until the conclusion of this age. Daniel chapter 9 also concerns a rebuilt temple in the remaining set of 7 years, so it is fitting that this 490 number points to Hanukkah Day 8, as Hanukkah is about the rededication of the temple. So, in summary so far, we have the start of the Revelation 12 rapture sign on September 23rd, 2017. Then we have the completion of the Revelation 12 verse 5 rapture sign on November 13th, 2017. The word sign in Hebrew means foretelling of something to come. Then we have the Hanukkah Day 8 and UN vote on December 20th. And as I will explain, the signs very strongly indicate the UN vote leads to the rapture and the beginning of the 7 years end times period 42 days later. Let's look at some other very interesting things. This diagram reveals the connections between ends of wars, blood moons, and the ultimate end of war. From the official end of World War I at 11:11 on the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918, we have 11,101 days until the first blood moon of the 1949 tetrad. This blood moon on April 13th, 1949 was also 333 days after Israel was reborn on May 14th, 1948, and 33 days from the end of the Independence War. From the end of the Independence War until the end of the Six-Day War to recapture Jerusalem on the sixth day, it is 6,666 days. From the first blood moon until the end of the 33-day Hezbollah war in Lebanon in 2006, it is 6,666 days times pi. The day of the end of this war was also the anniversary end of World War II. 6,666 days from this day brings us to the end of the age and the end of all war on the 11th day of the 11th month in 2024, which was symbolized by what was called the War to End All Wars, the Great War, World War I, when it also ended on the 11th day of the 11th month at 11:11 a.m. in 1918. God is poetic. I also find it interesting, in this example of his amazing poetry, that right as the War to End All Wars began, there was a famous eclipse on the first day of the month of Elul that was a sign of Jonah, judgment sign. And similarly, right before this upcoming seven-year period of war to end all wars, on Elul 1, there was also an eclipse that was a sign of Jonah, judgment sign. Now, let's look at the 7 years end times timeline. Because of the connections that could only have been procured by God in this end of wars, blood moons, and the end diagram, we can clearly see that November 11th, 2024 is at the end of the 7 years end times timeline. We know from prophecy that the 7 years period is 7 times 360 days, or 2,520 days. What is important to know from this diagram here is that it also shows us that the very last day of the 2,520-day time period is December 26, 2024, which is Hanukkah Day 1 in 2024. If we count back from this day by 2,520 days, Day 1 of the timeline is February 2, 2018. We can be highly confident that this timeline is correct because of the day counts and signs involved in this end of wars, blood moons, and the end diagram. However, there are three more astounding proofs for this timeline. First is the Japan tsunami connection. There are many astounding day counts that start from the recapture of East Jerusalem and the Temple Mount on June 7, 1967, which I cannot get into here. However, this particular connection proves the February 2nd beginning of the timeline. The 17th day of the month of Heshvan in the Jewish calendar is the anniversary of the beginning of Noah's flood. The 10th day of the month of Heshvan is the anniversary of when Noah and his family entered and sealed the ark, which symbolizes the rapture. The day counts are derived from a very significant day in 1967 when the Jews took control of Jerusalem for the first time since the siege of Jerusalem by the Babylonians in the 6th century BC. They are also derived from the number 120, which is the number God gave Noah until the flood. It is a symbolic 2,520 days from the Japan tsunami until the beginning of the 2,520 days end times timeline. This is truly profound, as it proves the February 2nd timeline. Another proof of this timeline comes from this connection with the number 1,440. 1,440 is the number of minutes in a day, which we get from the Babylonians. I don't have time to go over the astounding details involved here, but briefly, the number 6 in the Bible is the number symbolizing man, the number 666 even more so, and is in fact the number of the Antichrist or the false prophet in the book of Revelation. On a side note, this is the passage in Revelation 13:18. Quote, "This calls for wisdom, let the person who has insight calculate the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man. That number is 666, quote. The Pope's historic name in Latin, which was written on his scepter and mitre, is Vicarius Filii Dei, and using Roman numerals, the numeric equivalent adds up to 666. If 1,440 days represents a single day because a day has 1,440 minutes, then 14,400 days from June 7, 1967 to November 8, 2006, Heshvan 17, would then amount to 10 of these, quote, days, quote. Then the following segment of 1,440 days to October 18th, 2010, Heshvan 10, would be another, quote, day, quote, bringing the total to 11, quote, days, quote. The reason this is very interesting is because in 603 BC, the king of Babylon, King Nebuchadnezzar, had an astounding prophetic dream that the prophet Daniel interpreted for him. This dream depicted three additional kingdoms, Persia, Greece, and Rome, to rule over Israel and Jerusalem after the Babylonian kingdom, until the Messiah's permanent rule over Israel and the Messianic kingdom. From the time of Nebuchadnezzar's dream in 603 BC until the end of the timeline in 2024, it is 666 times 1,440 days, or if you will, 666 quote days quote. 666 times 1,440 days is also 959,040 days, which is 2,626 years from Nebuchadnezzar's dream in 603 BC until the end of the timeline in 2024. The 666 number thus represents the length of time of man's rule on earth and what is called the, quote, times of the Gentiles, quote, before the Messiah's rule. So here we have the Japan tsunami and its Fukushima disaster on March 11, 2011, tying into Nebuchadnezzar's dream with its four kingdoms until the end of the age. It is mind-boggling to think that a major event in recent history connects with an ancient prophecy about the times of the Gentiles until the coming Messianic kingdom, as well as providing proof that the upcoming 2,520 days end times timeline begins February 2nd. There's another amazing connection proving the February 2nd timeline that involves the blood moons, but first, the massive significance of the upcoming super blue blood moon on January 31st needs to be explained. Let's take a look now at the upcoming super blue blood moon on January 31st, which is also the day of Tu V'Shavat in the Jewish calendar. 2 days prior to this upcoming February 2nd and beginning of the 7 years end times timeline is the day of Tu V'Shavat in the Jewish calendar, which is the 15th day of the month of Shavat. This is one of four New Year's days in the Jewish calendar, and this one refers to the New Year of Four Trees. It is the season of change and marks the passing of winter into spring. It is celebrated with eating the first fruits of the trees, which is interesting because those that are raptured are said to be God's first fruits in the harvest. Jesus commanded that we be watching closely for the signs of his return, and the book of Ezekiel commands us to be God's watchmen. In fact, this video could be titled, Watching for the Many Signs of the Lord's Return. Tu V'Shavat, or New Year for Trees, is known as the day of, quote, watching, quote, watching for the first fruits of the trees, and therefore spring for trees. The almond tree is a tree in Israel that produces its first nuts at this time, and the word in Hebrew for almond tree is the same word as, quote, watching, quote. This Hebrew word is shakid, and in fact, God uses a very appropriate play on words with this Hebrew word in Jeremiah 1:11 through 12. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you see, Jeremiah? I see the branch of an almond tree, I replied. The Lord said to me, You have seen correctly, for I am watching to see that my word is fulfilled. The beginning of the season of signs in 2017 began on Tu V'Shavat, which was February 11, 2017. This date was also played out with more stunning math from God. From this day of watching for signs for the Lord's return, it was 156 days, or 490 days divided by pi, until the massively prophetic day of July 17, 2017, when Jews openly prayed on the Temple Mount for 1 day. After exactly 49 years of 360 days from the decree to rebuild Jerusalem in 1969. Again, the number 490 is astonishing, as it is the number in Daniel chapter 9 that is about the temple being restored in the last 7 years of the prophecy for 490 years. Also, once again, it was another 490 days divided by pi from this prophetic July 17, 2017 date until Hanukkah Day 8 and the UN vote. The number 153 is another very significant number in the Bible, as it refers to the harvest of souls for Jesus in John chapter 21. So it is also quite interesting that from February 11th, 2017, or Tu V'Shavat, it was 153 days until the day of terrorism on the Temple Mount on July 14th, which led to the Jews being able to pray on the Temple Mount on July 17th, and also another 153 days from this day until the first day of Hanukkah on December 13th. This was the day of Turkey's emergency summit of Islamic nations as a result of their rage over Trump's embassy move and symbolic gesture to confirm the truth about Jerusalem being Israel's capital city. So the symmetry here that is pointed to with this number of 153 are the 2 days of Islamic anger at Israel. The day of Tu V'Shavat 2017, on February 11th, the day of watching, began the season of massive signs of the Lord's return in 2017. So it is amazing that God also used undeniable math to point to this day in itself. Recall that there are three Blood Moons tetrads in the last 100 years, one surrounding the rebirth of Israel in 1947 to 1948, another surrounding the Jews' recapture and control of their ancient capital, Jerusalem, in 1967, and the 2014-2015 tetrad that points to the beginning of the end time 7 years and restored temple on the Temple Mount. It was 501 days from the historic UN partition plan to establish a Jewish and Arab state in Palestine on November 29, 1947, until the first blood moon of the three tetrads on April 13, 1949. Incidentally, the Jews accepted this UN partition plan, and the Arabs preferred a war to annihilate the Jews. Even though it made the Jewish state a slim sliver of land on the Mediterranean coast, gave the majority of territory to the Arabs, and in one portion made Israel only a few miles wide. Then, it was 501 days from the last blood moon of the three tetrads on September 28, 2015, until Tu B'Shevat on February 11, 2017. Which again was the day of watching for and beginning of the season of signs in 2017. So God has provided symmetry here with 501 days before the first blood moon of the trio of blood moons, and also 501 days from the last blood moon of the tetrad trio. It's also interesting that it was 50,001 days from the date the first agricultural settlement was erected by Zionist Jews on November 3, 1878, until the last blood moon. Named Petah Tikva, which means door of hope, this settlement began the fulfillment of the prophecy in the book of Hosea chapter 2 regarding God's desire to restore Israel with agricultural settlements and production. This day of Tu B'Shevat in 2018 is January 31st, and it comes 2 days before the beginning of the 7 years end times timeline on February 2nd. This date will also be the day of the first blood moon since the prophetic blood moons tetrad in 2014-2015. Like the last blood moon of the tetrad in 2015, this upcoming blood moon is a supermoon. It is also the first blue moon blood moon in 152 years. There is a truly astonishing connection between this upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon and the last blood moon. First, it is amazing that from the last blood moon, it is 700 days until the 120th anniversary of the first Zionist conference on August 29, 2017. Again, the number 120 is highly significant, as it is the number God gave Noah until the flood, and the number 700 is highly significant because the number 7 is used over 500 times in the Bible to show God's touch upon something. Then, from August 29th, it is 490 days divided by pi until the upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon. Here again, this amazing 490 divided by pi calculation shows up. There are three astounding signs derived from the golden ratio, also known as the phi ratio, that point to this upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon. First, if you are not familiar with the golden ratio, it is 1.618. Discovered by Leonardo da Vinci, it is a mysterious mathematical relationship that shows up throughout creation. For example, in proportions in the human body, plants, DNA, the solar system, art and architecture, music, population growth, and the stock market. Therefore, the phi ratio is a signature of God's. Theologically, adding unity to nothingness, or 0 to 1, produces the Fibonacci series of numbers, which converges on phi as it moves toward infinity. The golden proportion, or phi ratio, is the only way to divide something, such as a line, so that its parts are in proportion to, or in the image of, the whole. Only by trividing the whole does each piece retain its unique relationship to the whole. Only here do we see three that are two that are one. The first verse in the book of John captures the essence of this. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In John 14:9, Jesus said, "Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father." Here, the human Jesus, the Son of Man, is to the divine Jesus, the Son of God, as the divine Jesus, the Son of God, is to God, the Father or whole. What is amazing is that this phi ratio of 3 in 2 in 1 shows up in the relationship between the blood moons and points to the upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon. The total length of time from the first blood moon of the 2014-2015 tetrad until the last blood moon is 18 months. It is another 29 months until the upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon, for a total of 47 months. 18 months out of 29 months is the phi ratio, as well as 29 months out of 47 months also produces the phi ratio. This golden ratio also shows up in the relationship between the two Revelation 12 rapture signs and the upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon. It is 130 days from the Revelation 12 verses 1 through 2 sign on September 23rd until the Tu B'Shevat blood moon, and it is also 80 days from the Revelation 12 verse 5 sign on November 13th until the Tu B'Shevat blood moon. 80 days in 130 days is the golden ratio. So far, we have three major signs clearly pointing to the upcoming Tu B'Shevat super blood moon this January 31st. First, the last blood moon via the number 700, the 120th First Zionist Conference, and the 490 divided by pi number. Second, the blood moon's tetrad with its phi ratio. Third, the Revelation 12 signs through its phi ratio. This would be the three witnesses required to confirm a matter, as described in Deuteronomy 19:15. Yet another way in which God is clearly pointing to this upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon is by way of the two historic conference gatherings to condemn God's people. Just outside Berlin on January 20th, 1942, senior Nazi government officials gathered at the Wannsee Conference to ensure the cooperation of administrative leaders of various government departments in the implementation of the so-called final solution for the Jewish question. 42 days later, there was a blood moon on March 3rd, and then the genocide. Jesus prophesied that there would be another Holocaust of Jews in Judea and Jerusalem in the 7 years end times period. From December 21st and the historic UN vote to condemn Jerusalem and Jews' rights to their capital, it is also 42 days until the upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon on January 31st. Also, the year of the Wannsee Conference and its blood moon 42 days later was the year the final solution began in 1942. This parallel of 42 days is also interesting because 42 is the number of weeks that Jupiter circled inside the womb of Virgo in the Revelation 12 sign. 42 weeks is the maximum length of time for a healthy pregnancy. Jupiter symbolizes the church, and Jupiter gestating inside the womb symbolizes the church age. So therefore, this maximum of 42 weeks symbolizes God patiently waiting the maximum amount of time before the rapture and commencing judgment. Thus, this 42 days from the world's massively prophetic vote at the UN to condemn God and his word on Jerusalem until the blood moon also symbolizes God's waiting period before commencing his judgment on the world. Also, the number 6 is the number of man, and as we saw earlier, 666 is the number of the length of man's rule until Messiah's rule. 42 is 6 sets of 7. Additionally, in the Old Testament, the number 42 is used 4 times, and each time it refers to slaughter. This includes the length of time of King Saul's rule, which ended because he would not complete the slaughter God told him to. Also, the length of time of the Antichrist kingdom in the end times, which will slaughter many people, is 42 months. So clearly this number 42 is symbolically meaningful, as the number of days between the Wannsee Conference and the blood moon before the Holocaust, and also the number of days from the UN vote until the Tu B'Shevat blood moon and the beginning of judgment and the end times period. A fifth sign God is using to clearly point to this upcoming Tu B'Shevat blood moon is the connection between these supermoons. A supermoon is when the moon is at full moon and also at perigee, which is the point in its orbit that it is closest to Earth. According to NASA, a supermoon occurs on average once every 13 months. At the end of 2016, there were 3 supermoons in a row, which is quite rare. The middle of the three, on November 13, 2016, was the closest supermoon to Earth since 1948, making it a, quote, super-duper moon. 1948 is the prophetic year Israel was reborn as a nation, so this coincidence was interesting. We have now figured out how God has used this supermoon as a sign. From this supermoon, it is 444 days until the upcoming Tu B'Shevat super blood moon. Recall that it was also 444 days between the two star Bethlehem Jupiter-Venus conjunctions in 2016 and 2017, the conjunction in 2017 being the Revelation 12 verse 5 sign. So these two 444-day counts create symmetry. 444 days from super-duper moon sign to super-blood moon sign, and also 444 days from Jupiter-Venus conjunction sign to Jupiter-Venus conjunction sign. I don't have the space to go into details here, but there are a number of reasons why the number 444 is prophetic and refers to the end times. However, because Hurricane Harvey was mentioned in this video, I will point out that it was a Category 4 hurricane. It devastated the fourth biggest city in the U.S. with just over 4 feet of water, the historic record for amount of rain from one tropical storm. Also, there is a very interesting passage in the fourth chapter of the Gospel of John, John 4:35. Do you not say, there are yet 4 months, then comes the harvest? Look, I tell you, lift up your eyes and see that the fields are white for harvest. The January 31st Tu B'Shevat blood moon and the February 2nd timeline are just over 4 months from the, quote, great sign, quote, the Revelation 12 September 23rd sign. Quote, lift up your eyes, quote, in context of the, quote, harvest, quote, is a reference to the rapture. The, quote, fields are white, quote, could be an allusion to it being wintertime. Comet C/2017 E1, otherwise known as the Conception Comet, is a truly amazing sign in the sky that appears to have inseminated Virgo on November 16th, 17th, 2017, a few days before Jupiter entered the womb. If you're interested, I highly recommend watching the video made by the guy that discovered this sign on the YouTube channel named World Breaker. From this date, it is 444 days until the February 2nd beginning of the end times timeline, which makes this three instances of 444 days connecting signs. It is also 400 days from the Conception Comet until the UN vote. Jupiter exited the womb of Virgo on September 9, 2017, which was 9 months and 23 days after the Conception Comet. This is interesting because the Revelation 12 sign occurred on 9/23. Another prophetic proof that the 2,520 days end times timeline begins on February 2nd comes from the connections between the 2014-2015 Blood Moons Tetrad and the prophetic day of terrorism on the Temple Mount on July 14, 2017. As I mentioned, from the first Blood Moon on April 15, 2014 to the Tuba Shavat Super Blood Moon on January 31st, it is 47 months. This 47 months was shown to be highly significant due to its connection in the phi ratio between the Blood Moon's Tetrad and the January 31st Blood Moon. On July 14, 2017, terrorism took place on the Temple Mount, which led to the prophetic fulfillment of Jews worshiping on the Temple Mount for one day on July 17, 2017. The 2,520 days end times timeline that begins on February 2nd reveals that May 2nd, 2021, is the day of the profoundly important prophetic event on the Temple Mount known as the Abomination that Causes Desolation. This day is the 20th day of the month of Iyar in the Jewish calendar. This can't be a coincidence, because Iyar 20 is the anniversary day that the Jews at Mount Sinai, after coming out of Egypt, began their journey into the wilderness. Prophecy tells us that on this upcoming day of the abomination that causes desolation, a remnant of Jews that believe Jesus is the Messiah will flee for their lives from Jerusalem into the desert wilderness. If this May 2nd, 2021 is the day of the abomination that causes desolation, then 47 lunar months prior to this date is July 14th, 2017. This is stunning confirmation of the timeline that begins on February 2nd, as the terrorism on the Temple Mount on July 14, 2017, which led to prophecy fulfillment 3 days later, connects to the terrorism and the abomination on the Temple Mount. This connection is made through the highly significant number of 47 months that also connects the blood moons through a phi ratio clearly designed by God. In other words, 47 months connects blood moon to blood moon, and also 47 months connect terrorism event to the terrorism event. Here we have what could be called a tetrad of earthquakes. For those that have eyes to see and ears to hear, as Jesus said, there are amazing patterns contained within this that clearly reveal a designer to our world that has complete sovereign control over everything. In any given year, there are usually 10 to 20 7.0 or higher earthquakes around the world, or roughly one every 3.5 weeks. On January 10th this year, a 7.6 earthquake hit off the coast of Honduras. This occurred 177 days after a 7.7 earthquake hit off the coast of Russia on July 17th, 2017. This again was the massively prophetic day the Jews were able to openly pray on the Temple Mount for the first time. 177 days before this day, another 7.9 earthquake hit Papua New Guinea, and this too was 177 days after a 7.7 earthquake hit in the Marianas. The number of 177 days is very interesting, given this is the number of days that separated the blood moons in the tetrad. Yet this pattern of 7.0 earthquakes paralleling the blood moons does not occur randomly in time. It zeroes in on the prophetic July 17th day. Within this date itself, 7, 17, 17, we find sevens and ones, which hint at the number 177. Yet perhaps even more interesting is the pattern between the number of days between the first and last blood moons and the first and last earthquakes, and the number of days between the blood moons tetrad and the earthquakes tetrad. The number of days between tetrads is 306, which divided by 2 is a prophetic 153. Again, 153 is the number given in John 21, symbolizing the harvest of souls in the church age. And the number 153 is hinted at with the duration of 531 days of the tetrads. The number 531 is in itself a meaningful number, as it is the number of years from the second blood moon in the tetrad that surround the enormous calamity and expulsion of Jews from Spain in 1492, which had been their main homeland for over 1,000 years, until the end of the 7 years end times timeline in 2024. From this Spanish expulsion tetrad, there isn't another tetrad until the trio of tetrads that began with the rebirth of Israel in 1948. Chronologically, this particular blood moon connection from 1493 is the first blood moon out of the 16 blood moons in the four tetrads to have a connection to anything. So because this first connection is pointing to the end in 2024, this is more symbolic proof of the timeline that begins February 2nd. The last earthquake and the end of the earthquake tetrad on January 10th also splits evenly the symbolically meaningful 42 days from the UN vote until the Tu B'Shevat blood moon, giving us 21 days, which is three sevens, or God's signature, 777. 7 days after this earthquake, on January 17th, an unexpected skirmish broke out between 42 Jews and police on the Temple Mount after these 42 Jews began to openly pray after being provoked by Muslims. Jews are not allowed to pray at all on the Temple Mount. This second instance of Jews praying on the Temple Mount comes 7 plus 7 days before the Tu B'Shevat blood moon, and further confirms this symbolism of 42 days from the UN vote until the Tu B'Shevat blood moon. Watch this video a few times. Please pass it on to others, especially unbelievers. As a result of learning about these myriad of signs God has provided for us over the last few years that have required such unimaginable accuracy built into the creation from the beginning, I have come to the conclusion that this is just a sample of what we can see of God's awesome power. In fact, God's creative ability and wisdom must be infinite. I offer this metaphor for us watchmen on the wall. These signs are perhaps the tip of the iceberg of an infinite matrix of perfectly designed, quote, signs, quote, that is the creation. I'm sure once the veil is pulled back, we will see so much more of his awesome precision and wisdom. For those that are still not convinced the Bible is the inspired word of God, I hope you give it a chance and begin learning about the awesome and apparent divine architecture within the Bible, an architecture that is similar to these webs of signs that connect to each other. If the world-changing event occurs at the end of the month, as these signs do indicate, I hope you will bow down and pray for forgiveness for your sins and accept Jesus as your Savior and Lord. If you are a watchman and have an outlet for information, may I suggest putting this video out there so that people that are left behind may find it. God bless you all in this community, and thank you. I can't wait to see you soon. First, it should be crystal clear that all of this proves the book of Revelation in the Bible, which is about the revelation of Jesus as God. Jesus was not an enlightened master. He was not misquoted or misunderstood, and all religions and everything is not connected. The second coming is not a metaphor. Our God has designed an environment for us in which he has partially hid himself in order that we have an opportunity to choose either to seek him and love him and truth of our own free will or go our own way and remain in our pride. He has revealed this truth and light to humanity progressively over time according to his plan. The truth is that God is monotheistic outside of time and space and is too pure to accept us inside himself. All organisms must reject foreign substances that come into their bodies in order to maintain their integrity. The solution for mammalian mothers to be able to incubate their offspring without rejecting the foreign DNA of the babies is the placenta. The placenta is the solution because it consists of 50% of the DNA of the mother and 50% of the DNA of the baby. This is a fitting metaphor for how Jesus is our solution for overcoming the sin that is in the way of a right relationship between us and God the Father. God is good and therefore righteous and just, and so sin must be paid for. It is a mystery, but Jesus is able to take on our sins for us through his death and resurrection. As Jesus said, by being in him, we can be in the Father, and no one comes to the Father except through him, that he is the door and the gate, and the way, the truth and the life. Every other religion or worldview has devised a method of getting right with God. This includes Eastern and New Age spirituality's attempts to connect with the, quote, God within, quote, or, quote, universal consciousness, quote. Only biblical Christianity recognizes that this is folly and pride. Pride is the root of sin. God is seeking humility. You must repent of your sins now while you have time and make God number one on a list of one. You need to watch my other videos. Also go to the additional resources section of my website where you will find a collection of the most astounding videos on every topic you can think of. From archaeology that proves the Bible to near-death experiences to spiritual warfare and amazing testimonies from a woman formerly deeply involved in yoga. If you were left behind after the rapture, here is some information that I think will help. The Roman Catholic Church and the Pope are the Antichrist system. I expect the Pope will announce to the world the arrival of aliens and that they have chosen him as their world ambassador. The deception will be strong and aliens will be demonic deception. The mark of the beast, which if taken is a ticket to eternity in hell, may not be a literal mark on one's body, but will involve worship in the New World religion, which many strongly believe is an amalgamation hybrid of New Age ideas and spirituality and charismatic Catholicism and Christianity. The theme will be, quote, spiritual evolution, quote, and the unifying element will be seeking personal spiritual experience and silencing the mind with things like yoga, meditation, and contemplative prayer. 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verses 9 through 12. The coming of the lawless one is by the activity of Satan with all power and false signs and wonders, and with all wicked deception for those who are perishing, because they refuse to love the truth and so be saved. Therefore, God sends them a strong delusion so that they may believe what is false, in order that they may be condemned, who did not believe the truth but had pleasure in unrighteousness.